Welcome back again to my channel. The only thing we hear in this country is bad news and insecurities, and I think it's because Nnamdi Kanu is in custody. That's why the Southeast is very insecure, which people have said, Peter Obi have said, Kanu Tokunbo have said. So I read from Sarah Reporters. Breaking: unknown gunmen kill three vigilantes, teenager in Imo State, that is Southeast. So according to the eyewitness, the vigilante were attacked when they were on security patrol within this community. A vehicle belonging to a local vigilante group in Imo State has been ambushed by unknown gunmen. The attack happened in Njaba area of the state on Sunday evening, which is yesterday evening. According to an eyewitness, the vigilante were attacked when they were on security patrol within the community. The eyewitness said three vigilantes and a teenager were killed by the gunmen. It was gathered that the vigilantes were patrolled on Sunday evening in a vehicle in the community when the gunmen attacked them at Afo Umuaka in Njaba. An eyewitness reported that the assailants set up an ambush and began shooting at security personnel. According to him, a stray bullet struck the teenager, who died on the spot. The gunmen overtook the community security Toyota Sienna the security men were patrolling with and shot them dead, the source said. Security has deteriorated in Imo with frequent attack by gunmen. Confirming the incident, the State Police Command spokesperson Henry Okoye said a tactical squad had been deployed to apprehend the attackers. The Commissioner of Police Imo State Command, CP Apoki Danjuma, has strongly condemned the attack and gruesome murder of the vigilante personnel of the Umuaka Autonomous Community by gunmen on Sunday evening, being the 7th of July 2024. In the wake of the tragic incident that claimed the lives of three gallant vigilantes who were on routine crime prevention patrol and a passerby, the Commissioner of Police has deployed the command tactical squad with the available operational resources to go all out in synergy with other security agencies and hold down the hoodlums responsible for this dastardly act. CP Abuki Danjuma expressed sadness over the unfortunate incident and vowed that the command will leave no stone unturned in ensuring that the perpetrators are all arrested and brought to justice. He emphasized with the family of the deceased victims and prayed for the repose of their souls. He said, these are only the news we hear in Nigeria, insecurity, and yet they say we have insecurities. In Nigeria, could you imagine that other countries are all equipping their security people? They are all emphasized and looking into the security aid sectors in their country. But here we are in our country, we are only hearing bad news. The only thing that the Southeast security people are after is all this money they collect at checkpoints. Now they don't even take the vehicles. A criminal can come out and give them 15 naira and go. Somebody can be carrying a dead body in the boot of his vehicle, just give them money and go. They don't even do that work again. They don't even search the vehicles again. All they are after is collecting those money. And the reason why they're doing that is because the government are not paying them well, and also the country is very hard. These are the things you see. You don't blame anybody, because the country have made it so hard for everybody. Everybody now doing anything they can do to get money, because they all have families. The small money that the government are paying them cannot take care of the family, so they have to go out to make some money, which is standing at the pools and collecting money from people. These are the things that are causing more insecurities in Nigeria. If only the government can look into security sectors of this country, that only we can have security. And pay them enough money to take care of their family and let them know that they are here for this work. Because you can't pay them little change for them to go home and feed the family when they have a family of 4 and 5. Salary cannot even feed the family. So they have to go at checkpoints and collect money to be able to add up to feed the family. These are the things that cause security. You can imagine every single time we're heading security, especially in the Southeast. I think the government should wake up and do something about this insecurity that's happening here and there. In Imo State, we know what happened during this lawsuit at home, that they killed some military men and burned and set their car ablaze. these are the insecurities that are happening in the South, is which the government needs to look into. By the way, guys, this video you have watched, any of you in the comment section, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share as we look forward to know how what else happened in Imo State. If those hoodlums we are able to set justice, I'll bring to this to you guys. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. See you guys.